If I should fall, set this up for us. Tell us what this is about.
The way we sort of approached the film was through telling the story of one, we want to tell the story of many. You know, like, how do you tell the story of 158 soldiers? Through telling the story of one, we aim to tell the universal story of loss.
We just wanted to be able to share some of the true stories of the people who have been involved with the Afghan War in several different ways.
I felt so proud because I respect the suit. I respect men in suit.
As a father, as a parent, you know, I was always scared of, you know, the moment that he will leave us.
As much as I can appreciate any of the applause that is given for me receiving this award, I'd like to direct that applause towards the soldiers who this film is about.
One of the big things about this film that I want to be able to get across is that I want to be able to take the theme of Remembrance Day beyond Remembrance Day, as simple as that sounds, and that's something that every Canadian can be a part of. So,
absolutely. Brendan Culleton, director of If I Should Fall. Find out more at ifishouldfall.com.
One of the pallbearers for Marc, and there wasn't no way that I wasn't gonna be, you know, like, it was everything
Marc's given to me. It's time for me to give it back and to be there for him and to carry it and make sure that it's done honorably.
I thought about his family, I thought about Mary. I never got to carry him off because of my rank, but I got a chance to take his medal, and to me that was just as good as carrying his casket.
There's no greater honor than carrying somebody that died for the country. Your friend. You can't beat it. It's the worst feeling ever, it's the best feeling ever.
I can't speak for anybody else, but I mean, for me, it would be an honor to die for my country. I'm sure everybody else that signed the dotted line would say the same thing. I mean, you have to go above and beyond yourself. Put everybody else first, because if you think about yourself, you can't do your job.
As soon as we left the base, and you see people with all these signs, holding signs and saying thank you. It was unbelievable to see all these people, you know, come out and salute this young hero. There was like 12 bridges that we passed under, and they were full of people. People that left their homes, their left their jobs, they took days off to just be there, you know.
I feel really hurt inside. Just like if you lost one of your own, you know, that's how much I feel, you know. It gets me.
It's my way of respecting the families and the soldiers, and I don't want them to think that it's something that they've done where nobody cares about.
It was great. It was amazing. I just couldn't believe it. It really touched a lot of us, Lebanese immigrants here in Canada. It's a good country to die for. You know, after seeing all this and experiencing how soldiers are treated was great. Dying for a good cause is something, and dying for nothing is something else, you know. Here, these soldiers die for other people's freedom, and that's a big thing. It's amazing. It's amazing.
Please remember me. Please remember.